Every winter, crop farmers have to make a decision about what kind of crop insurance policies they're going to buy this year. One of the aspects of that decision is what units they want to put into their crop insurance policy. We have several choices, fortunately, ranging from optional units, which insure very small parts of the total operation, to whole farm units, which, as the name implies, one policy for the entire farm. In between, we have several other choices, basic units where some of our tracts can be combined if they're owned or cash rented. We can't combine crop share leases because that land is, we have only a percentage interest in that crop and the landlord has the other percentage. Enterprise units basically include both crop share, cash rented, and owned units all in the same tract, but still insuring each crop separately. The whole farm unit, as it implies, we combine all of the crops into one policy. A little more detail on enterprise units. First of all, you have to be growing the crop in two or more sections. That refers to township sections within where the land that you either own or rent is located. And at least two of those sections must have at least 20 acres or more. So basically, we can't insure very, very small land parcels as a separate policy. If the total acres add up to less than 100 acres, then at least two of those sections must have 20% or more of the total. So again, avoiding insuring very small parcels separately. Now, why might we want to combine parcels into enterprise units? The main reason is to spend less money, lower the premium. The subsidies to crop insurance premiums, multiple peril crop insurance from the risk management agency, depend on the coverage level that we choose and the type of units that we choose. As you can see, looking at the left-hand column, our coverage levels can vary from 60% up to 85% of the expected revenue from the crop. And as we increase that coverage level, the percent of the premium paid by the USDA goes down. But we can offset a lot of that by moving to larger crop insurance units, particularly if we look at, say, for example, the 80% coverage level. If we have optional or basic units, the USDA pays 48% of the premium, the farmer pays the other 52%. But if we move to enterprise units, in other words, combining some of that rented and owned land into one policy, it goes up to 68%. Now, combining crops doesn't really gain us that much. We go up maybe 3 percentage points in some cases, no increase at all in the subsidy. So as you might imagine, the most popular choice among farmers is enterprise units. Let's take an example. We'll say our farm is in Linn County, Iowa. We're going to look at corn. We have an indemnity price this year of $6 per bushel with an approved yield of 160 bushels per acre. And we'll say there's 300 total acres in the land that's being farmed. We'll assume we're going to buy a revenue protection policy. In other words, we're insuring gross revenue. Now, this is a comparison of the premiums for the different levels of coverage and comparing optional, basic, and enterprise units. Again, if we took 80% as our coverage level, for example, you can see optional units or basic units are about the same, about $33, $34 per acre. If we go to enterprise units, we basically cut our insurance bill in half, just under $17 per acre. So it does make a big difference when we do go to enterprise units. So the advantages, we get the same coverage levels for lower premiums, or conversely, we can spend the same amount of money and get a higher guarantee. The risk protection against lower prices is the same. It doesn't matter whether we combine the units into one unit or we have separate units. The effect of lower prices is the same. So we don't give up any risk protection against low prices. Now, we do give up some protection against lower yields because, of course, the production from all of our land units is combined and commingled for purposes of calculating our actual revenue. So that is one of the disadvantages. If we have isolated losses, for example, a hailstorm that only affects a portion of our land, we may not get any payment if we get a normal or above average crop on the rest of the land. So it reduces the probability of getting at least a small payment each year. Some producers, one of their objectives is to get at least a small payment from their crop insurance each year. So they're probably better off with the optional units. And we still need to keep separate production records on each farm, just in case we want to go back to optional units someday, or if we should stop farming a particular rented farm. So there are a few disadvantages to enterprise units. Now, if we think that the probability of an isolated loss, and usually this is going to be due to hail or strong winds, is something that we're concerned with, you can purchase a supplemental hail and wind policy. These are private policies sold by the various crop insurance companies, and those do pay indemnities for isolated losses on small land areas. Enterprise units work best if we only have two or three basic units, so we're only combining a small number of basic units, and if the farms are fairly close together geographically, or if the yields are very closely correlated. In other words, if we have a loss on one farm, is it likely we'll have a loss on another farm? If these farms are close together, maybe touching each other, that's fairly likely. If they're located in different corners of the county, then it's much less likely. And in that case, we might be more apt to want to purchase optional units rather than enterprise units. It also makes a difference as to the type of risk that we are most concerned with. If we're mostly concerned with price risk, there's really very little reason not to buy enterprise units because a lower price affects all of the units equally. If we're more concerned with yield risk, then we may prefer to insure each of our farms separately. Finally, if you can self-insure the small losses, enterprise units work better because typically we will not get paid for small losses, but if we have large losses on all of our farms, then the payments will actually be higher under the enterprise units. So next time we go to our crop insurance agent, think about the different tracts of land that we're farming, where they're located, how closely correlated the yields are in those farms, and whether we're more concerned with insuring against low prices or low yields. That will help us make the correct decision each year about what units to choose for our multiple peril crop insurance policy. This has been William Edwards, Extension Farm Management Specialist, Iowa State University.